In this video, I'm going to go through the new course builder interface that comes with LifterLMS, the full-featured learning management plugin. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I release a ton of content to help you get better results with WordPress faster. If you're new here, please consider clicking on the subscribe button. And if you'd like video notifications, there's a little bell off to the right of that. You can click on that and YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. And this video specifically is going to be added to this playlist. I have an entire playlist here on YouTube going through all the steps of setting up an online course website using WordPress. It's a great resource and the numbers are doing pretty good right here. It's been out a few months and the playlist already has 42,000 views on it. That's good. I'm very happy because this is kind of niche, but it's a very hot topic these days, creating online courses. So the tutorial series uses LifterLMS, which recently came out with a new update to revamp the course builder. Here is a site that I have LifterLMS on. Let me just show you the old course builder. I'll show you how to update this, and then I'm going to show you the new course builder. So the old course builder, I would click on courses right here, and then I would click on the course. And I'll show it to you right here as I scroll down. Here is the old course builder. It was within this box on the actual course page. And, you know, it was fine for me. Now, when you want to edit anything on a lesson or create a new lesson, you're working in these like dialog boxes. So if I went to add and then add a new lesson, we were dealing with all these little pop-up boxes. And with the new course builder, you're not doing that. Also, dragging and dropping lessons is easy for small courses. But if you have a course with many, many lessons, dragging a lesson here from the bottom up to the top could be a little tedious and a little problematic. So there were things like that. Also, if you wanted to change the name, you'd have to go and get into, you know, click on the click wheel here, and then you have the pop-up, and you have to wait a second, and then there you go, you have your lesson title. It's okay, but if you're constantly in the lesson builder, it would probably be a bit on the problematic side. So they released a ton of updates and revamped the entire thing. So you can just go ahead and click right here and update your LifterLMS. Now, after you update it, since this is such a significant update, there is an actual update process that you have to go through after just updating the plugin itself. Now, depending on how large and active your courses are and your course website, it might take a minute, it might take 10 minutes. For me, on my website, it probably took about 25 minutes because it's very active. So now when I click on LifterLMS right here, the plugin's updated. I'll probably get that notification. Oops, that didn't go good. Maybe something changed there. Okay, there we go. So right here, I'm getting this notice, and it says, click this button to run the updater. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Click on OK. It's probably going to go really quick on this website. You'll get this message that it's updating in the background, and it'll just do its thing. So now let me actually show you a website where I've already updated it. So I'm going to go to courses. I'm going to click on courses right here, and I'm going to click on the one course that I actually have, and you're going to see that list of your sections and your lessons is gone. It is completely disappeared. Now what you do is there'll be a button here off to the right. Now you can actually move this if you want to move it to the top. You can just drag and drop this to wherever you want it to be. You might actually want it on the top. This will actually carry over to all of your courses if you've moved it up to the top like I've done. Now if the button is looking funny, don't worry. This is because your web browser, the caching on your web browser needs to be cleared. So you can do that through the settings of your web browser or try this in a different web browser. And that's if this button looks funny and when you click on it, things don't look right. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it like this, and it takes a few seconds here, and then it opens up the new course builder. Now the course builder, it's so much faster. It is way faster to do things. So before I showed you how you had to click on the little gear icon in order to get a wait for a pop-up. But the pop-up comes and then you can change information. Now I can just click right here, just like that, and I can start changing the names of these sections just like that. So I can do this a lot quicker because I'm not waiting for pop-ups. Now, these are all the sections in this course, and they're already collapsed. So you can hover your mouse cursor on any section, and then you can see an option to the right there that says expand section. And then here you can move a section up or down, but you can drag or drop it by clicking on this. So if I wanted to move this section up, I could just go like that. Or if I wanted to move it down, I can click right there and it moves it down instantaneously, and I can delete a section. And right here, if I wanted to, I can click on expand all and it will show me everything and collapse all. So if I just wanted to work in one section at a time, I can do that, or I can just get the view of everything just by going like that if I wanted to. And right here, you can click here to add a new section, a new lesson, or add an existing lesson just like you could before. There are a few updates to this new course builder. This wasn't there initially, and it was just brought back. Thank goodness, because I actually use this a lot. So if you want to add something new, if I click on section, you can see it just adds it right here. I can click on it, and I can get to customizing the name and everything immediately. Let's see what happens when I click new lesson. You see the lesson goes there immediately. Now, you might want to put this lesson someplace else, and that's super easy to do. You could just drag and you can drop it into the module that you want. So here I am in section two. Say I wanted that at the end. There it is. Now, off to the right of lessons, there's different icons. So when I hover over the name, we get edit lesson settings, view lesson, and then you can do the shift down like that. And if it was here, you would have a shift down and a shift up. Then right here, you can detach it from the course. And right here, you could delete your lesson. And then you have these little indicators here to let you know what the status is of the lesson, if students are in it, if you have any prerequisites, a drip, a quiz assigned, or you have content on it. So this does not have content or any of these settings. That's why you can see it's completely grayed out. Now, part of the reason they built this new course builder like this, and I am actually glad that they did it, because you could just be focused on the syllabus of your course. It's very visual. It makes it a lot easier to drag and drop and move things around, and a lot quicker to change the name of lessons and stuff like that. So this here is the new course builder that comes with LifterLMS. I'll have everything linked in the video description box if you'd like to check out LifterLMS, or if you need the link to this playlist right here. And let me know what you think of this course builder in the comment section down below. Hey, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.